Good morning, everyone. So it's day three in beautiful Rome. We're actually heading home tonight. We're heading on a really late flight tonight. I think our flight's at like 9:15 p.m. We've just had a little stroll because we haven't been this side yet. We haven't come this way yet this trip. But we've walked to the Spanish Steps and here they are. We are heading to the Vatican City today. We haven't eaten yet this morning, so we're going to get an Uber straight to this place called Celiachiamo Lab. Another gluten-free place, but it's like a bakery, but also a gluten-free supermarket, something like that. But it's meant to be really, really good and has croissants and donuts and things. So I'm really excited to do that. And then we've booked the Sistine Chapel and the Vatican Museum. And then we'll head to the airport and get a flight home. But we've had a lovely trip so far, so let's go to the Vatican City, and it's its own country. It's the smallest country in the world. So that's pretty cool. And the Pope lives there.
I am in celiac heaven right now. Look at all of this stuff. Gluten-free, we've got loads. We've got croissants, donuts, cream-filled donuts, biscuits, all of these cookies and tarts and cakes. They've got all these pastries. I am obsessed. And we literally bought loads. There's also a whole supermarket full of gluten-free stuff. And then they've got a fridge of everything. They've got fresh pasta. And then look at these pizzas. Oh my God, I'm in the best place ever. This is possibly the best place I've ever been in my life. And we've got a whole bag of goodies.
I am so excited. 13 euros for a whole bag of goodies. We've got pizzas, we got shoe buns, we got donuts, we got arancini balls. I'm set. Okay, so we've just tried some of those gorgeous bits from Celiachiamo Lab. I hope I'm saying that right. I'm really sorry if I'm not. And oh my goodness, that pizza was the best gluten-free pizza I've ever had. Better than yesterday. I mean, yesterday was really good, but yesterday I had like a white sauce, a creamy sauce rather than tomato sauce, but that was like a ham topping, ham and mozzarella pizza, and that was just perfect. I'm stuffed. Yeah, that was really good. We had that. The potato croquette with ham in it was amazing. Very similar to the ones I had yesterday, but with ham in it instead. And then I tried a bit of Tim's arancini rice ball. It was like a tomato one with mozzarella in the middle. It was nice. Tim said it would probably rate second in the arancini that we've had this trip. He said his favourite was the first one we had on day one from La Patissiera, or whatever that place was called.
This is probably third. The one from the risotto place was good as well.
Yeah. What else did we try? The nugget. The chicken nugget was so good. So crispy and nice. And then we've just tried a chocolate donut, sugar donut, which was really nice. It was a bit dense, but
I liked it. Not a dry.
Yeah, it wasn't dry at all. It was lovely.
A bit more Nutella would have been
really. Yeah, a bit more chocolate would have been perfect, but oh my gosh, so good and such a good price. Tim said it came to like £13 for all of it. Is that right?
13 euros
for all of it, and I'm just blown away by that. And to Monzo it's 11.57. What a bargain. But I've got a filled croissant in there because I really wanted to try one of the croissants. What else? We're gonna head to the Vatican Museum now, and it's like a 5-minute walk from here, so let's go. So I have just tried this croissant, and it's like got this cream on it, and oh my God, this is unreal and all gluten-free. Apparently you can't take food into the Vatican Museum, which is a bit annoying because obviously we've got all these goodies, but we've got some time to kill now, so we're just going to eat it all. And then we're going to go in, and we're sat just opposite the Vatican Museum on these little steps. Tim's eating his biscuits from Roscicoli, something like that. Okay, everyone, so we've been here like an hour and 15 minutes and we're still not at the Sistine Chapel, and it's been so long, but we've been able. But well, we're here now. Okay, so I'm going to show you the Sistine Chapel now. Hopefully it's worth it because this has been long. Okay, so we're almost out. We've been in the Sistine Chapel. You're not actually meant to take photos in there, but we'd already taken some before they then said, don't take any pictures, but everyone's taking photos in there anyway. But it's very beautiful, the artwork was beautiful, but we are ready to go. We're ready to get out. It seems like a lot of walking for the Sistine Chapel, if that's what you're interested in. And to me and Tim, it just seems like it's a lot of the same stuff, but it's still beautiful and we can still appreciate it. But I'm definitely glad we didn't do a guided tour of this one because we've just been doing like a self-guided tour so we can rush through the bits that we want to, skip certain bits, things like that. But yeah, we're on our way out now and I'm not sure what we're going to do next because we've got quite a bit of time before we need to go to the airport. Hey everyone, so this place might look familiar because we're actually sat at the same bench that we were sat at earlier. We did the Vatican Museum and the Sistine Chapel and that was about it because me and Tim are just wiped out, to be honest. So tired. Our feet are hurting, I've got blister on my baby toe, which is killing me. We literally sat and had a drink each in a little cafe and then we went into a football shop for Tim and then walking back near the place we went earlier, the Celiachiamo Lab. So I went in there and got some dinner because I'm not going to eat anything at the airport and our flight's not till 9 p.m. tonight. So I just went and had another one of their pizzas and then I bought two of the little potato croquette things with ham and then a little shoe bun. Is this a shoe bun, Tim?
Well, it's like a fritter roll.
Like a fritter roll. It's shoe pastry. All gluten-free, of course. So I've got that. Also, everyone who's been to Rome knows this, but see this water fountain? All the fountains in Rome just run water constantly and they're all drinking water, so literally we haven't had to buy another water, just filled up my bottle, so that's good. So yeah, I'm gonna eat my little potato croquette things. Let me show you one. Look at this, right? So good. And then we're going to head back to the airport and go home. It's home time. Try to be honest.